Hello. Would you like to try latest, newest cutting edge OpenStack on a stable platform? Would you like later move to the stable one without wasting time for a transition? Here's an idea. Let's take a quick look at the agenda. If you will have any time, please hold until the end of the presentation. I will make a time slot for a Q&A. Who we are, an RDO. Let's take some numbers at the beginning. Current release is RDO's first 21st OpenStack major release. We are managing 330 OpenStack packages and 365 dependencies on the current releases. Also, at the end of the January for CentOS 9 master branch, we had nearly 14,000 package builds. What does RDO may mean? Maybe there are ridiculously dedicated OpenStackers who rapidly deploy OpenStack, or maybe remote daily, regularly delivered OpenStack. But jokes aside, the RDO means an RPM distribution of OpenStack. In short, we are a community-supported OpenStack distribution. We are testing and deploying on CentOS Stream. The RDO can be deployed by different deployment tools like Tupelo, Backstack, Puppet modules, or any other custom tool you can do for yourself or what suits you. In general, we provide two different sets of repositories for different purposes, RDO Trunks and CentOS Cloud 6. Let's start from scratch, so from general concept of packaging, as the most basic part of a building complex system. I know that for many of you, those concepts are familiar, but I would like to keep this presentation consistent so anyone, but I won't get much into the details. What is a package then? In most general words, the simplest explanation is a way of distributed code. This is also a bundle of files needed to install software. It could be also a way to specify dependencies between software components and perform some prior setup actions. Packages are easy to install, easy to manage. By a proper tool, you can install it, version, track, verifying, and do all the other stuff you would like to do with your software. Packages are also a very initial brick for building complex systems like clouds, like OpenStack. There are many ways of creating packages out of the source code. Its usage depends on the kind of package format which is desired. There might be a distro packages like RPMs, or there might be language native packages like PyPy for Python and all the other corresponding ones. For RDO project needs, we are focusing on a distro one. But inside the distro packages family, there are also many different formats like RPM, Deep, Tar, Flatpak, and a bunch of them. And they can be run and built and managed by all the other package managers like RPM, again, Pacman, APT, DNF. Well, I think there's been no surprise when I said that in RDO project, we are using a Red Hat package manager. How the packages came into being? Packages to be built has a specific receipt, a set of instructions, how the package should be built, what dependencies does it have, what tools should be used to build a package, and finally, what the package should contain. In RPM-based world, we call these files spec files. It's a short from specification file. And all the package details are configured there. These files contain several mandatory sections, which sequence is not accidental. We use some of them to shape dependencies at packages at RDO. Of course, they are not all of them, and the specification files can be a very, very complex one. And this is just one we are mostly interact with. We have a preparation phase when we can do some actions on the source code before we start to package it. The phase of building, the phase of installation, the check ones when we run the test on the package, the files when we are specifying what will be on the user system, and two important directives which are very important for RDO, the build requires and the requires directives, which you can say what dependency will be used for building a package and then what will be used for a runtime of it. Building a one package is a matter of simple command in the right tool, but continuous delivery or the whole repositories for a rapidly developed project like OpenStack, that's a challenge. Once I showed you an initial steps, it's time to change a perspective and take a look at the task globally. In every project, there have to be a kind of organization rules or a single source of truth, which would answer the questions like where, what, on what condition, in which version. In RDO project, this role is carried by a RDO info repository. It contains essential information about packages, dependencies, releases, maintainers, and all the others, and the important fundamentals. The information there are stored in a set of YAML files. RDO info is also used for any automation we are doing in the project. Any adding or updating packages has to be done through the change in content of the RDO info repository. Digging through the hundreds of lines in YAML files is not the most comfortable way of searching information in RDO info repository. So we have to have a very mighty tool in hands of packager, which calls RDO PKG. And it provides for us as a packagers some abilities like cloning package diskets and setting remotes, introducing new packages, rebasing, sending changes for a review, modifying specification files, and at the end, querying for RDO info metadata. Here's an example of output from RDO PKG info for our OpenStack Octavia package. What's important here is a set of URLs. We have a section build stacks, which is quite important because as you can see, here's a definition what version of the packages should be used for any particular release. Next, we have also a section for tags. This is a section where we are saying if for any branch, the code should be pinned to the branch commit hash or anything, and also the list of maintainers. How new packages are added to the RDO project? In RDO, we are managing two types of packages, OpenStack packages and dependencies. For OpenStack packages, they are coming only from upstream OpenStack projects, like, for example, OpenStack Cinder of OpenStack Nova. They are created and built by RDO, and they are built by DeLorean, our automation tool, or by CBS, CentOS Community Build Service. The dependencies, on the contrary, comes from any upstream project. They are coming from Fedora, and they are built by CBS only. Note that we are providing two kinds of repositories, RDO Trunks and Cloud 6, as I said in the introduction. And both of them are composed from OpenStack packages and dependencies, but inside it, they are just shipped differently. No matter if OpenStack package or dependency, they have something in common, and this calls a distro repository. And this is where all the specification files live. Together with a source code, they are taking a part in a building process of package building. How can we add a new dependency package? The procedure I'm showing here is a very simplified model of it. If you'd like to have some more details about it, I invite you to check our RDO documentation. So for a dependency, the package has to be present in Fedora repository. If not, the procedure of adding new Fedora package has to be preceded. And this is basically a way how I became a package Fedora packager. Then, if you have such a package available, the package has to be marked as RDO dependency and RDO info repository. You just have to say that, hey, this dependency is now our dependency, we will use it. And then we have a procedure of tagging and promoting, which I'll explain later. What about new OpenStack package? On the contrary to dependencies, they don't come from external repository, but from RDO info itself. If you would like to request for a new RDO package, it's done by a review bug in Red Hat RDO product bugzilla. And the same like for dependencies, new project has to be created in RDO info. This will trigger some necessary automated tasks like creating repository and synchronization, doing some and adding some CI checks, and all the other CI jobs which is needed. And in the end, the review with a new specification file for a new package can be sent and reviewed. Beside the dependencies and OpenStack packages, RDO also maintains Fedora OpenStack 6. Its purpose is to maintain and ship latest packages such as OpenStack clients, libraries, and dependencies in Fedora. The procedure of update is the same like for any others, with the small difference that the disk maintenance is done by RDO community and then is synchronized to Fedora. As we already knew how to add a new package, we should take care about the packages which we currently delivered. In RDO, we are trying to stick to the upstream code as close as it possible. And for OpenStack trunk procedure, we are monitoring the upstream projects. Let's take, for example, OpenStack Nova. The new commit is merged to OpenStack Nova, and this is monitored by our DeLorean automated tool. If we have such an issue detected, creating a new commit, we have a new package built by the DeLorean tool. And if the process is successful, we are creating a new repository and publishing it in our RDO trunk servers. And this repository we are publishing here, this is not only the package, this is a whole repository with this package, contains not only the new package and the latest builds of the REST packages in the same release. Speaking about RDO trunks, I have to mention the upper constraint files. In general, in OpenStack world, there is a requirements repository containing a global requirements list. In RDO, we are basing on it. And this list is basically the list of the highest upstream CI version, version of the package or library. And depending on this list, allows us to constantly follow OpenStack development. Speaking of trunks, I have to mention that we have two approaches there. For one, we are respecting the upper constraints file, and these are our main builds. The output of that builds are going to the CentOS 9 Master, CentOS 9Z, CentOS 9 Yoga trunks, and all the others we are building for. But we also have an additional prediction workflow done only for a CentOS Master when we are not respecting the upper constraints. And this approach allows us to predict the difficulties difficulties with a package build with a future when the upper constraints file will be updated. To maintain the continuous delivery of the packages, we are monitoring the changes in upper constraints repository. And when it's changed and updated, we are creating an automated gated review with a proposal. And after the approval, it's merged, and that's how we updated our upper constraints. What about updates in Cloud SIG? On the contrary, we are not looking at the new commits. We are looking at the new releases there. If it's created in master, on a dedicated branch, automated review in corresponding disk is created. When it's merged, new package building in CBS is triggered. Of course, if it's successful and the promotion mechanism is done, we can say that we have the package updated. On the screen, you can see the example of the change triggered by a new version in a release. This was done for a Magnum disk git, done by our RDO trunk automate. You can also note the set of the jobs triggered by this change. For dependencies packages, the update was done for a long time in a manual way. So we have to go manually for each dependency and make a manual review to update it. But recently we introduced a new tool which is automatically proposing dependency updates for a currently developed branch. So how does it work? First, we are checking if there is something to update. This is done by a nightly CI job. And as I will repeat, it's only done for a master branch. If such package is detected as available to being updated, we are getting the NVR name convention of it. NVR, name release version, is a naming convention which is quite a unique identifier of the packages. And by using this NVR name, we are going to the Fedora and looking for these packages, for the needed version of the package. If it's not there, the workflow will of course fail because, as I said, all our dependencies has to have its beginning at the Fedora, But if it's there, and if no other review is opened for that package, we are proposing a review with a new version. Here I want to do a little break for the journey and share a word about our main RDO tool, which makes the continuous deployment possible. The tool named DeLorean. Its main task is to provide repository with a new package build, but in general, DeLorean is a generic tool for tracking any upstream project. Maybe it will be used for it could be used in your project. The name is referenced to be able to go back in time. The repositories created by the DeLorean are not changeable, will not be overwritten in a time, and are stored in a unique commit hash name-base directory. Of course, all the build history are limited to the storage restriction. I would like to tell you that you can back to the half a year ago build, but unfortunately, it's not that great. But still, you can go back for some time back in a time. Here's an example. How does it look like? If you go to the trunk rdoproject.org, you will see the list of latest build, latest results of our building. And by choosing, for example, CentOS 9 master, you will see such a list. We have provided here a build date, commit date, the commit hash, and with linking to the exact commit which triggered the change, a link for logs, and a link for repository itself. Take a look closer at the difference between a commit date and build date. I don't know if it's visible enough, but it's about around 4 minutes, and it will be important in next slides. But how the repository looks like? At the top, you can see this unique name I mentioned based on the commit hash. Inside the repository, you will see a bunch of commit logs, build logs, and then they are started to going packages in the NVR name convention. Shortly about this convention, to make it clear, we have two examples here. First one is for OpenStack Nova package. And it's very easy because the version is 26.1.0 and it released first. And the another example is coming from a DeLorean. Is that special because the release, as you can see here, is not that easy because the release is basing on a timestamp. We also adding a commit hash, which lets us identify the commit, the source commit, and of course the extensions. When we are trying to build the source, not always everything goes well. Sometimes we are having something we called FTBFS, failed to build from the source. The reasons are different. It can be infra issue, it can be missing dependency, it can be break dependency or anything, basically. And if we spotted such a situation, we are seeing it is in our RDO trunk, and you also can see it because it's upstream. And we are providing the guaranteed review with a logs and all the information about the building. I have to mention that all the FTPFS has to be as quick as possible fixed in our RDO project, and this is a kind of our daily basis job to keep the DeLorean builds clean and clear. Here is our help, little help for this job. This is a report of FTPFS when we have all the data aggregated with the links, with the release, which was failing inside, the review logs, the date, and everything in a one comfortable place. Time to deliverables. So in simple words, what's it our product? In RDO, we are delivering two types of repository, RDO trunks and RDO Club 6. These repositories are managed and delivered in different ways, and in this table, you can see the comparison of them. What's important here? To not mix the idea of a single package, which can be dependency or OpenStack package, with the idea of an entire repository, which are trunks or Club 6. And as it goes for trunks, they are only built by DeLorean. New package in DeLorean are triggered by every new commit. They are delivered very close in time after new commit. And this is about these 4 minutes I mentioned to you about, which was visible in the screen. For trunks, we are fetching the code as pulling all involved repository. We are doing a continuous delivery for a master branch. Keep in mind also that in RDO trunks, the packages are unsigned and are delivered in RDO, a trunk RDO project servers. On the contrary, we have a Cloud 6. They are built only by CBS, and new package building is triggered by every new release upstream. which implies that they are delivered rather in days or hours than minutes. The source code is fetched by tarballs. New repositories are released after the OpenStack GA. All the packages in Cloud 6 are signed and are delivered in official Cloud Mirror, CentOS Mirror in Cloud 6. So going to the more details about the repositories. For a Cloud SIG repositories, we have two types of repositories there. Keep in mind that both of them are published after GA of upstream release and are published only for stable branches, which means that we have no master here. So first is CloudSig GA repo, and which contains only tested packages and are intended for production environments. And the second one is a CloudSig testing repo, contains only partially tested packages and intended for testing and development environments, but the packages there are very, very fresh and very new. For audio trunks, they are delivered continuously. So it means that we are doing it also for a master. When a new release appears, master DeLorean builder is still following the upstream master, but there is a created new builder instance for appearing stable, new stable branch. And inside DeLorean, we have the three kinds of repositories provided: the current, the consistent, and current pass CI. So the current one is a repo with the latest version of every package that was successfully built. What's important about this repository? This is repo which allows the situation when one of the package failed to build from source and is in version behind the current master. So keep in mind that not all packages in this repository can be up to the latest commit. On the contrary, you have a consistent repository which has no such a issue as current. So it contains only only packages with no failures, and it means that if we spotted FTBFS for this repo, it will just not be published. And the current pass CI, this is also a repository which has no failures, but is also verified by the CI jobs to ensure the stability of this repository. Let's take a look where we are in a wider perspective. We do know now where the packages came from, what are the spec files. We made a closer view on our main builder tool. We have also some idea about managing versions in RDO info. So now it's time to introduce the process of promoting packages to ready release state. As a promotion, we understand the mechanism of moving packages from one phase to another. We are defining three kinds of package phases: the candidate, the testing, and the release. Between each phases, there are performed various tests, including a package installation on a different OpenStack deployment with this currently tested package. How does it look on the schema? So let's assume we have a new package of new package version merged. And at this point of view, this this package has a tag candidate. It's not available at this moment for in any repository. But we have a CI job which monitoring what packages are in a candidate state, and automatically it proposes it to the testing one. After a set of CI jobs and approval of RDO cores, we can say now that the package is available in a testing repository and there is a possibility to use it exactly, but it's still in testing. Then comes another nightly job from CI and monitoring what is in testing and not in release. And at this point, we have the most complex CI jobs to monitor what is happening. We have the different kind of deployments here to make the best integrational test we ever can. And the workflow you can see here is only applies to the RDO trunks repository and to the Cloud 6, which are already released. For a non-released one, the process stops at the testing phase. This is an example of a change to promotion from a testing to release. Pay attention to the set of jobs which was performed here. Here on the screen, you can see a promotion monitoring dashboard. Not always everything goes well. It's rather a temporal infra issue, but usually not so red. But I think it looks fine. Okay, now as you already know how promotion looks like, it's time to say a few words how new release looks like. OpenStack is having major release around every 6 months. And in RDO, we are trying to stick this upstream schedule as close as possible. And to maintain this delivery pipeline undistracted, we have to do some actions before the release. First, we have to do some fixes in RDO infrastructure. At the beginning, we have to add a new DeLorean builder, so the instance which will be designed for this coming release. Then we have to create some CI jobs for incoming release. And at the end, add this new release to all the automation bots and scripts we are having. When we are done with the infrastructure update, we are going to another task, which is quite a faithfulness, and it's about updating diskets. What we have to do is go to all the diskets we have about the packages, libraries, and everything we have, and basically verify if the app dependencies is up to date, if anything new appeared, or some dependencies are deprecated, or just change the version. It's take a lot of time, and to help us, we have again this our RDO PKG tool, which will help us to identify what dependencies should be updated. After having the disk is up to date, we are moving to we have to create a new branches in all the disks. And after having a new branches, we have to have a builds for these branches. And at the end, we have an additional task, which is a pinning a branches projects in RDO info. Not all the upstream projects we are using in RDO are creating the branches. Some of them have branches, but it doesn't suit us. So at this case, we have to take this project and pin it in RDO info to a specific tag, commit, or branch. Here we are. So we started from a basic source code, and we know how to fetch it and build it. For all our automation tools, which makes the continuous delivery possible, up to releasing new repositories for trunks and CloudSix. And even if our project is mature, we still have many works to do, still many ideas for improving our workflows. Currently, OpenStack RDO Z release is the newest maintenance, but there is coming featuring Antelope. And as you can see on the screen, it's going to be released at the end of the March. And this is something we are currently working on to be prepared for the new release. What else? Some time ago, Fedora switched to a new PyProject macros as the recommended way to build Python packages. So as we strongly may depend on the Fedora packages, we are planning to introduce these macros in every package. Of course, we are not going to do it manually. We have to develop some automation for that, but it's not that easy and obvious task. And this is still before us to do. And another way is a new monitoring. On our daily basis work, we are use multiple dashboards to make our work easier. And as you see before, this is an example of our FTBFS dashboard, example of a dashboard which helps us to identify the packages which are behind the upper constraints file, not only for master, but here for all the all the branches we are taking care. And at the end, the dashboard you already see for a promotion. And what we would like to do about this monitoring is to put it all in the one place. There are the plans to integrate all of this in a single Grafana dashboard hosted by a software factory, which we closely collaborate with as our infrastructure maintainers. And the problem of the monitoring we already have, that this monitoring is very diffused. It's different technologies and different places. So we know it's not that the greatest tool to monitor what's happening in our project. There is work needed to be done in data migration and part parsing, and then also in designing this new Grafana panels. And in the end, I would like to say a few words how RDO influenced the CentOS ecosystems. We have two issues here. It's about testing. as the OpenStack is a very complex system, which definitely requires a lot of different resources. So that's a great integration platform to test CentOS on a multiple level. As the RDO is testing and deploying CentOS on testing, it gives a lot on CentOS, it gives a lot possibility to improve the system and the ecosystem, the CentOS ecosystem. The other matter is a 6. And not only CentOS Cloud 6 is using RDO. The RDO members participate in a launching new 6. We are active maintainers of them. For example, messaging 6 or NFV 6. In the end, if you would like to join us, I'm inviting you to visit our page. We are also all available for you on a RDO channel, RDO RFC channel on our FTC server. And we also have our weekly meetings every Wednesday at 2 p.m. If you have any questions, I'm here for you. If you'd like to contact me or find me, you can find me on the RDO IRC channel on OFTC, and my username is Karolinko.
Thank you for the talk. I was just maybe less of a question, but more of a comment. I was always inspired by RDO info approach, and since I moved from OpenStack to RHEL and Fedora, I always wanted Fedora or RHEL or CentOS to adopt this approach where you have all metadata about all components in one like repo with YAMLs, where you can really see all the release engineering information, ownership, and everything in one place. I really wish we find a way to have similar setup in CentOS or Fedora or both. Unfortunately, don't know yet how. So thank you for a nice talk and good memories.
Thank you. There was another question.
Are there any questions? Let me check the live stream real quick. All right, no questions in the live stream. So
thank you.
Yeah, thank you.